we're going to take a look at adding and managing users on your site. So a lot of people do everything themselves and they don't have to add other people to their sites, but some people take on projects with their friends or use it for a business, or maybe you hire somebody to help you with your site and you might need to give them access to do things like that. So we're going to start at my home, which again is just WordPress.com, and it'll take you to the site that you worked on last. If you want to switch to a different site or you have multiple sites, you can always go up to switch site up here. So we're going to scroll down a little bit and we're going to look at this user management specifically. And if I just click on that at a high level, it's going to show you who has access to this site. It's going to tell you what role they are. And I have these guys as they're all admins right now. You can also see the different levels of users. So followers to your site don't necessarily have any power to edit content or do anything with it, but they receive notifications and pay attention to what's going on with your site. Your email followers are kind of like your email subscribers if you have that hooked up. And then invites will show you if you've invited somebody and they maybe haven't accepted that yet. So let's play around with a quick flow. If you want to add somebody to your site, you're going to see a few different things. So I'm going to go ahead and click on invite. And what you're going to see is you can add them based on either their WordPress.com username or their email. And then you have these roles. Luckily, within this, there's kind of descriptors under each role, so you can determine what you want to do with that. The reason you might have this in place is because you might not want to let every single person have full control of your site. So if I want somebody to help me with content, but I don't want them to add plugins or change my design or something, I might make them an editor. If I don't want them to edit and change all the content, I might only let them be kind of a contributor and edit their own content as an author. They can add photos, they can create content, they can publish their own posts, but they're not going to be able to edit my content or other people's content. You can also, if there's people who want to write or add content to your site, but you don't want them to kind of have full control over publishing that, contributor is a nice role because they can edit their own posts, but they can't publish them. So they can create content, it can go in the queue, and then you can kind of review it before it goes live. And then there's this subscriber role where they can basically see things on your site, but not really have any control over it. There's other plugins and other roles and things like that that you can add based on your needs. So it's pretty extensible. There's lots of different powers you can give people or take away depending on what you need. But these are kind of the core default roles that go in there. And then obviously when you send an invite, you can give them the context by adding a custom message here before you send it out. So that's pretty basic. Your admins are going to be able to do everything, add plugins, change theme, change content, whatever. Your editors are going to be able to change all the content on the site. And then from there, you work backwards to how much you want to limit their capabilities.